So we begin the planning for the when workshop. Day before yesterday, you have had a meeting on administrative matters, and at that time it has been decided that the dates will be 14 June. Which is a Tuesday, to 24 June, which is a Friday, and although there are 11 days, we will not have any sessions on Sunday, 19 June. This will be the off day. That's frozen. Next, 34 centers. All of us who are present here, now coming to the topics and themes. First one is, I had split these into 13 topics, out of which we treated 12 very well. We didn't have much time to consider introduction to cycles. So let's first consider first 12 topics, and their sequencing is okay. Later on, as convenience, because there are a large number of lectures, I may split them into, you know, group them into subtopics, but these are the 12 main topics. Okay, what about topic 13? Include what we did today plus basic analysis of cycles. Now if you look at the exercises, provide me feedback, because we haven't had time to look at exercises, you will notice that we do basically all cycles, but we do not complicate a cycle too much, but we include isentropic efficiencies of compressors and turbines, we include regeneration, effectiveness of the regenerator is also included. Some explanation out there will be necessary, what is meant by effectiveness of regenerator. When it comes to regeneration in a steam plant, we just consider contact heaters, which are mixers, and we do simple problem with one or at most two contact heaters. We don't do exercises which we do in energy conversion with, you know, n contact heaters or n flash heaters or n drain cooled heaters and things like that. In this we restrict ourselves in this particular course only to maybe a single contact heater. But if they know how to handle a single contact heater, they should be able to handle other contact heaters also. I mean, more number of contact heaters also. So chapter 13, cycles. Now with cycles included, do you think there is any possibility of including other topics? Because we will be solving large number of problems in the, see I will tell you what, in compressible fluid flow, if you talk about, we will be essentially talking about the thermodynamics of compressible fluid flow. Which one? Let me see, the feedback is here. I'll go by that and decide after some time. But generally the thing is, cycles have to be included, right? So all 13 topics. and sequence is okay. Now regarding the goodness of topics, whether to increase or decrease, I will look at it. But is there a general consensus that more time and more emphasis has to be put on certain topic? Do you think that there was a topic on which even now we should have or we could have spent more time? Second law and? Okay, so there are still some question marks. Okay, we will definitely spend more time on that. See, on availability, I think if I spend more time on second law, I do not think there will be any need to spend more time on availability, because availability is just application of the two. Anyway, each topic will be spread out in the final lecture, because by default everything gets twice as much time. But some topics may not need twice as much time, so that will go into, as you said, second law. Thermometry can be compressed?
Yeah, it can be lowered fast, but it can be more second.
No, anyway, I am going to get double the time. So, if keep the same time for thermometry, see, I spend maybe an hour and a half on thermometry. Okay. I will spend only an hour and a half there. By default, I can spend 3 hours. So, those additional time will go in second law, more problem solving. We have not solved many problems here. And remember, their problem solving will take time, because we will have solutions ready with us, but we should force the participants to solve problems. You know, here I just gave you the scheme of things and you said, okay, now we can go ahead. There I think it would be a good idea, because most of those people will be juniors to you, although they will be teachers or teaching assistants, they will all be juniors to you. So you should force them to solve problems and throw out anyone who does not come with a calculator. Make that thing, and can you get local copies of the steam tables? Okay, you have the address, etc. So 30-40 copies shouldn't be any. How many of you use Mathur Mehta steam tables? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, theek hai. So if you don't mind restricting yourself to Mathur Mehta steam tables, just try to get at least for this workshop the Mathur Mehta steam tables. Because that way, you know, everyone is at the same level. Otherwise, you know, temperatures differ by a fraction, enthalpies differ by a few kilojoule per kilogram. And once it also happened that I had one steam table, someone else had some other steam table, and the end state was, in his case, subcooled, in my case, superheated by a few degrees. In his case, dryness fraction 0.98. So such funny things happen. Answers don't go drastically off, but it's better to have, so that I can say refer to this page, this thing, and see this. But what do you think is the comfort level of teachers and students with steam tables? Teachers are comfortable. What about students? How much effort does it take to become comfortable with steam tables?
Thing is that 20% of them are
the
out of a class.
20%
of them bring the
teacher
to
class. The others just listen, or
then they take all the figures, whatever are there. In general, reluctance of browsing through the
That's left to you. It's a local decision whether to give it to participant or whether to keep them with you and use locally for other batches or whatever. But one thing is, you know, we zeroed in on Mathur Mehta because we first came across Mathur Mehta around 1990-1992, and at that time we found that the cost was only 2 rupees or 2 rupees 50 paise. Information was slightly less, it has become fatter, and from 2 rupees it has gone to 20 rupees, inflation and fattening both included. But at that time and even now, I believe that it is one of the most widest range and this thing. Is that true? If there is something else which is better than that, we will include that. There is no harm. So we will restrict, I mean, we will say that Mathur Mehta steam table. And we will say n copies as required. Will be obtained by each center. And I will leave it to you, because what to do with them is left to you. Whether to collect it back or give it to those people. Then personal calculators compulsory. Make it very clear. Scientific, we don't need much, but we need logarithms once in a while, exponentials once in a while. If we do detail, pi we need, but we don't really need sine, cosines, hyperbolic, sines, cosines. I think apart from the normal things, only exponential, I mean, t raised to gamma minus 1 by gamma and logarithm, that type we need. We need, don't need very jazzy ones. I'll put simple scientific. Now, coming to the presentation format, what is the general feedback, tablet or paper or, so that means you are leaving it to me, okay, then you tell me, yesterday for example, I did open systems on a presentation, pre-cooked presentation, okay. So was that okay?
Okay for only open,
okay for only open system. That means for property relations it was a bit too fast, right? Okay. See, the disadvantage with a tablet is that the handwriting is no good. But of course, now that I know I have to use tablet, I will have a tablet, I will start practicing with it. No, on Monday when I started, it was, I had spent maybe not more than half an hour for a day playing with the tablet. And that is why still I am uncomfortable. I open it and it suddenly turns 90 degrees and then I have to call him and say straighten it out. Yes, that is true, because it is as near the chalk and board as possible. But the, you know, quite often I get, I said that look at this equation, I point it here, but nothing happens there. Whereas at least on paper, when I say look here, my hand and my pencil is seen. But yes, but out of nothing a line comes, right? Like a ghost it comes there. But let me see, either this or a good document projector.
There is a
marker
available, but a paint.
Where? This one. But that is only a highlighter. It's like this. Ah, okay, okay. I think that's a good idea. You say that PDF good only for open systems. Because you are comfortable already with open systems, no new thermo principle is involved. Yes, sir.
In the main workshop, as the lectures are being transmitted or being live telecasted in the different centers, okay, so only workshop coordinator or local coordinator is there. So your live presence will be more felt by these forms other than video forms.
Okay, here at least you are seeing me in person, whatever I am doing. There people may be seeing only my chota picture in the corner.
So this will be more effective if you use this form for all the topics. Of course, you are very much comfortable for open cycles as well as open systems
and cycles. Okay. So I think what I will do is I will prepare my presentation saying that these things have to be there. Just the way sometimes I refer to my, this book contains my old documents. So this only I will pre-cook, otherwise I will have this thing ready.
If you are going to give us same format for the pre-cook, so that would be very much appreciated. But it is up to you.
No, but the general tendency, general feel is
which cluster we are as attendees. So in
live work, yes, I think that's a very good point. That here maybe pre-cooked, but I am here in flesh and blood. Out there, the pre-cooked will totally be detached because they don't see me, they only hear me coming out of nothing. And that too through an internet, the voice quality also reduces.
As you said, sir, during these two particular lectures, there may be a lot of queries. Because we all are knowing the topics well and we might be prejudiced because of our previous work. Same thing will happen in main course and that may be difficult for all of us to handle it locally.
Okay. So then what I will do is I will use the PDF only for open systems and for cycles. Everything else will be done like
one small addition from sir, as minimum as possible.
Because as far as time is concerned, those 10 days, it is sufficient time. And when you write something, participants also write something and it prevent them from going into some sleeping mode, maybe in the afternoon.
And so, but that also means of, this is not technical, you are going to feed them tea, biscuits and lunch, right? See to it that that's going to be summer time. So see to it that there is no afternoon siesta by providing a proper, quote unquote, proper lunch. Okay. Don't feed them too much, or if you think they are getting fed too much, give them some masala chai or something soon after lunch. Yes, sir.
Is there any question comes from different centers? The time required to answer for these questions for different centers also time consuming. So here only 37 participants are there. Still we have spending a lot of time. Whereas no, you are concentrating,
yes,
on 34 centers.
I know. So,
how to restrict that?
There will be some questions which the local coordinator may be able to answer because of the exposure here. The request is as far as possible assimilate all that you have learnt. We will have an interaction. What I will do is I will see if the Moodle site comes up fast. If it comes up fast, it's okay. Otherwise, I will set up a Google group for us. Now, I have used Google groups even for our relatives when we are visiting somewhere. So, everybody knows what we are doing. So, there is no difficulty in setting up a Google group. We will start on that.
Sir, in your pre-cook format, there is a problem.
Yes,
suppose you are starting from the first line, the people may look at the last line because I don't know
because
where
that printout is already given to you.
Yeah, because printout is already there, so the concentration moves away. And once you write, then specifically, particularly, the person focuses on that thing only. He never looks on the next line.
Okay, that's in fact, that is why one of the questions which I asked is when I have those pre-cooked slides. Shall I give the, I mentioned that I don't want to give the slides well in advance. I must, yesterday also, I gave you only the first one when I started and I gave you open systems when I started open systems. Only after asking you whether you want it. Otherwise, those papers would have gone waste. But out there, I can't afford to provide you one print per my projection. Okay. So out there, it is without that overlay. I am saying 8 lines. That's good for presentation for me, so that you are not distracted. But you have the whole thing with you, so you know what is coming.
And when we do the kind of simulation for the presentation, then the mathematical steps follow in a particular sequence.
Right.
Whereas when you provide such kind of thing, all the steps are appear simultaneously and then it gets distracted. So it is always beneficial to go by.
No, here it is live action. You don't know what is coming. Even I don't know what I am going to write. That depends on what you say.
That is why this is what we preferred over that. Thank you.
No, I have no idea. I don't think, because if there is any local expert, I don't know what, who, which local, what expertise, and with 34 centers, it will be very difficult. If each center wants one local expert for half an hour, gaya kaam se, 17 hours gone there. That is more than 3 days. But that's what I said, that if you have, you are one per center. Okay, you are exposed to me, but I am sure at a few places there would be others who would be almost as good as you, and if they want to help out, the only thing that will help out is some very minor questions, some clarification, some misunderstanding can be taken care locally by you. For that, if you have a quote unquote local expert or a good technical friend, absolutely no harm in making use of him or her. It is also possible that participant 1 has a query which participant 3 can clarify, let it be. Because it is, you know, every time you send the question through the coordinator to the central thing, there is going to be a jarring thing, because I will have to say here, there seems to be a question from Sivakasi, and then over to Sivakasi, somebody will say click, click, and then the question will be asked, and I will say. And then after that thing is over, okay, now back to the mainstream. Okay. This is bound to happen because there will be questions. With 34 of you, there were enough questions. With 34 into n, I don't know how many questions will be. But I am sure there will be a number of routine questions which locally you can handle. So you should handle them.
Sir, I give one suggestion.
Yes, sir.
Let the coordinator discuss the difficulties.
Coordinators discuss the difficulties whatsoever they face in their center. If coordinator is not able to solve the question, his difficulty, then he may contact you. So one, in that way, only 34, you have to attend only 34 coordinators.
Yes, no student, I suppose, directly contacts me. It is the coordinator's job to put him through me. I think there is some protocol like that which is being set up. So, suppose there are, say for simplicity, there are 20, so 340 into 20, 680 students. So 680 students, if they raise their hands, any one of them, nothing happens. The student should raise his hand, the local coordinator should see what's the problem. If that cannot be solved, then wait, I will contact Mumbai. That's how it should be. Yes, so that is why. And that is why this coordinator's workshop is 2-3 months in advance. And I hope soon you will be getting the PDFs and other things of this. So that as far as possible, you should be in a position to handle.
Excuse me,
locally.
Sir.
Of course.
Excuse me, sir. In fact, last workshops what we have done, the coordinators used to collect all the questions first, and after that, they used to scan these questions and those
mail them to
questions
us.
Used to be asked by the coordinator. Yeah, it is on.
No, it will be
the questions. Not all the questions. The coordinators used to select specific questions and then ask it. The coordinator has to ask. Immediately or after the lecture.
See, end of every lecture, there will be a series of questions created locally. Some of them the local coordinator will be able to handle, in which that case that story is over. If he is unable to handle, they are sent to us by email or that chat window. Then what will happen is, from 34 centers, I will give some, maybe on a given topic, I will get maybe 30, 40 questions. But those may not be distinct. There will be common features in many one of them. So it is my job to satisfy all those questioning people. So long as I am able to satisfy them, it's okay. Perhaps it's possible that the same question or a very similar question comes from 10th, may not be all 34. Maybe comes from 10, 15. So those 15 questions essentially collapse into one.
Sir, I think.
And that is why, you know, whenever in a class or in a meeting like this, 5-6 hands go up, I select one of them and the question is asked and I reply. Many other hands then go down because it was the same question. Or if a hand comes up, it's only a supplementary to that. Such things are bound to happen. They happen in any class, so they will happen here also.
Sir, yes, there should be some more clarity to prevent this staggering of questions. Maybe if we are deciding right now that say one class is over and then it is open for questions, then we are allowing some 3-4 or at the max 5 questions. Then others will realize that 5 questions are over. Whatever the questions, those are not answered, they will write to you maybe in the evening and the next day you can answer. And then accordingly you can choose that 5 centers are over, the another 5 centers should be given a chance, so that people will have some understanding.
And another thing is, once this Moodle comes up, many of those interactions will take place through Moodle, every day evening or of lecture times. And once that Moodle is operational, Moodle doesn't switch off after that. For example, my thermodynamics Moodle, I keep it alive for quite a few time after that. But before the next thermodynamic thing begins, I switch it off. I mean, even those students or others cannot sign up. Because that way, you know, there will be some common stuff. I don't want them to look at them in advance from that point. Now, that means I will restrict to pre-cooked presentations only for open systems and maybe cycles. Okay. And that means one day before the open system session and one day before the cycle session, I will mail each center, or I will make available through Moodle to coordinators, the PDF of that. And you agree to print it and give it to the students just before the lecture begins. Okay, otherwise, they are going to fall asleep. Okay? That you have to agree. Just the way I gave you, just as the lecture started for property relations and just as the lecture started for open systems. Property relations I will not use. For open systems, I will modify it, because some figures were not very clear, so I will clarify them. It is your duty, you promise that they will not be distributed less than 0 minutes before the lecture. The lecture begin and then you can hand them over. And my idea of problem sessions, that we will have all the solutions ready, but they will not be available to the participants, they will be available only to the coordinators. I will solve some problems, but maybe I will give 15 minutes for saying, now solve this particular problem. And then you should be, because you have the solution with you, you should be able to see to it that locally they are able to solve. Of course, there will be some person who will go totally off track. If you can't make sense of that track, that can be referred to me. Will it be a good idea to give some exercises or homework to be done overnight, which you can locally check? Yes or no? Why not?
So generally they are maybe they want to maybe have some their free time from 5:30 to morning till, because morning again 9 o'clock they want to study. So keeping them always occupied with
not always occupied, maybe once in the first week, once in the second week, an exercise taking not more than say hour or hour and a half, not every day, or across that gap day. We have a gap on Sunday, so I can give some exercises occupying maybe, because it's a Sunday, maybe 2 hours, Friday till Monday, Saturday till Monday morning.
So those are all the young teachers.
It's so they should be easy for them to work.
No, it's sort of a tutorial. They means it is very easy for a tutorial to be solved in a team, like team of 3 or 4.
So if let them solve it in the team of 3 or 4.
Sir, I doubt it's, but we can try always.
Okay.
We can try.
Then can I, for example, the very first quiz which I gave you, that what I called prerequisite test 0. I feel like modifying it and using it in the clicker format on the very first day. Okay. And you have that thing, but that you are not going to show to anyone. Of course, you know all the answers are more or less useless, but even the questions you are not going to tell anyone. I may modify the questions and they will get modified, because everything will have to be, a clicker has how many option buttons? 5, A, B, C, D. And also yes, no. So if it is yes, no, I should say A for yes and C for no, something like that. And can I set a time limit, 15 seconds or 30 seconds? Is it adjustable? No, but one thing, I can conduct a quiz either clicker based or worked out. Say once every 3 days, 5 to 5:30 could be a test time. And clicker based, I can do anything, anytime. Clicker should be ready. Okay. So I think rather than homework, such a test will be better.
The important thing is you are not physically there at every center. So that is.
And I don't see many of them. I see hardly anyone of them. Only when they ask questions, I can see something. Otherwise, it's uncomfortable for me also, because at least here you are in front of me in fresh and blood. At that time, I'm
nobody
just a camera in front of me and a few people like this.
Then sir, why they are not adapting the similar workshop over here for the
No, the reason is the moment you have those, a few students, maybe 15, 20, my attention gets focused on them. I forget that I am talking to a camera with maybe 600 or 1000 people on the other side. It is necessary for me to be conscious of the camera, because camera is the representative of the 1000 people who are on the other side. If there is a camera, but for example that you are here, I just even don't worry that there is a camera there. It just goes out of my mind. That shouldn't happen. Otherwise, the moment that happens, all coordinators within the first hour will start saying UNG is neglecting us. You don't want that to happen, right? Of course, I'll allow a few students, maybe faculty members who are interested to sit, but they should not be in front of me. Baju mein baitho. And I will not be teaching them. I will be teaching the camera. It's difficult, but then I have to do it.
Sir, one suggestion regarding the home assignment. Instead of keeping Sunday off only, if you make say the course starting from Monday and finishing on Saturday, so that we have two, Saturday and Sunday in between as the off days, during that we can have this.
No, test. But now I am not thinking in terms of homework. Homework they will do by default. If I declare on Monday that on Tuesday afternoon we are going to have a test. And by default I will keep it 5 to 5.30 or 4.30 to 5.30. So that they will be, as somebody said, they will remain alert almost through the day. And at any time I will say take your clicker out. Okay, so I will say test 0 with clickers. And we will say, I will say a few clicker based questions each hour. Okay. And 30 to 60 minute quiz almost every other day. And what I will do is these tests or quizzes, I will send to the coordinators a few hours in advance. Okay, so keep a Xerox machine ready to print them. And soon after the test, I will send a model solution and evaluation scheme. So I will leave it to the coordinators and the TAs to evaluate that. Is that okay? Otherwise, you will have to scan the whole thing, send it to me, and then. Yeah. The clicker based is, you know, sort of a feedback every thing.
Sir.
For example, when it comes to open system, you know, the tank problem. Do you think it is necessary to consider if the level is going up and down? The work done by the atmosphere or on the atmosphere? Yes, no. 15 seconds. And if overwhelmingly say no, then I have to spend 5 minutes demonstrating why it is necessary. And if it is only, you know, if 90% against 10%, I will say the majority is right. But may I request the 90% to explain to those 10% why it is necessary? Which one? All the material, for example, everything which you have seen here is going to be made available in a PDF format after a week or two. Okay, because just now what has happened is all these things, one day I am going to get one file of so many hundred pages of PDF. And for simplicity, I have told them the files are simply thermodynamics day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4, day 5. Then I will, you know, just rearrange them and cut them as the intro lecture, then the 13 topics will have 13, and maybe each topic I will have sometimes two, saying this and exercises, because in between second law and problems on steam, they were mixed up because of some time management. So I will just cut and put them at the appropriate place, and those PDFs will be available. Either I will mail them to you. I think just now a list of participants has been given to each and everyone. And just confirm that particularly the email address in that is perfect. Character by character. If there are any corrections, let us project them just now. So that not only me, everyone else knows. No, but if there is an underline with a gap, for example, Selvane space SLM, that is Selvane underscore SLM, right? Gap with an underline is underscore. Because I think nobody allows a backslash space type of thing in an email address. I think there is only one such case, or is there more? CB Pawar. S. Karthik, Rajkumar Thermal. And anyway, I will get an electronic copy of this, so in which case that underscore will properly be copied. So your phone numbers and your email IDs, mainly email IDs, we are not going to call unless there is an emergency. should be perfect. So, question paper, email from here. Marking scheme.
We are following over here.
Huh, that's a good question. See, in the out here, what I did was the very first exercise. Remember, I went through too much of a detail, step by step, unit by unit, conversion by conversion. Now, what I want is when you submit those exercises, I want the exercises to be in that much detail. So maybe generally when you solve for yourself, you may solve in maybe half a sheet. But the way I explained it that day, if you solve it writing each and everything, in fact, that also was not complete because I was saying something. Okay, you should write the solution in such a way that nothing more needs to be said, including multiply equation 2 by 3, subtract equation 3a from equation 1. All those things should be written. So it may become 4 or 5 pages. Scan it and send it to me. Okay, because remember the solution will be used not only for you to explain to others, to local, but it will also be used by 33 others in 33 other centers. So let us, you know, by default assume that each and everything, but if it is in Word format, my request is, because Word is anathema to me, anything which Microsoft or Windows, I don't like. I use this Microsoft because I have no choice. It has been given to me. So if you do it in Word, somehow convert it into a PDF and send it to me. I have no problem. And if you scan it, see to it that the scanned version is also a PDF. Don't send me a JPG or TIFF or something like that. Okay? If it is scanned, handwritten and scanned, make it a PDF scan. If it is a Word or any other format you use, please convert it into a PDF. If you can't directly convert your package into PDF, nicely print it out, scan it into a PDF. I think everybody has a possibility of scanning into a PDF, right? That shouldn't be a difficulty. That means at most you will have to go through a print in between.
Sir, my query was related to a tutorial session. As you have said that day that you are going off from the screen for that 1 hour or 1.5 hours.
Not 1 hour and 1.5 hour. In a tutorial session, I may decide to have a 1 hour tutorial session. But that may be 4 problems of 15 minutes each roughly. In which case, I will say, now solve this problem. I will be available, but I will not be interacting by default. But I will be available for questions from coordinators during that time.
My request is, if you explain one or two problems before begin of
that will be done. That will be done.
Like you have explained to all of us.
Yes, that will be done.
If you for a particular process.
Yes, for a typical illustrative problem.
Yeah.
I can't do that for each and every problem.
No.
Right?
Typical problem.
So I want to follow the same method. For example, the exercise which I did. I like that exercise because it has a large number of issues involved in it. 2 components of work, 2 process diagrams, 1 P against V, 1 something against time, different units. So maybe that problem or a similar problem I will solve as a Dumbo thing. Other problems in others I will solve in a structural manner, saying this is given, now calculate this. I may not calculate it, but now you say, now first complete this solution in detail. And then I will say after 10 minutes, now I hope you have obtained all the solution. Now I will tell something funny about the next problem which is to be solved and say now 15 minutes. And now with this problem, you would have understood how to handle this. So now proceed somewhere else.
Yeah, this will be better.
That is the type of scheme I plan to follow.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, as far as questions by clickers, they are concerned. I think some sufficient time, maybe 2 minutes for each question should be given, because there is a relay delay of some 6 seconds itself. Rather than so just that day we have demonstrated some 30 seconds for each question, some 2 minutes should be given so that the category of non-responded will be less.
Okay. That anyway on the very first day morning we are going to have that session, so that will put all of us in the same. So tutorials, I will say first problem. In great detail, then others, method of solution plus provide time for students to obtain. Detailed solution. Okay, and that also means that exercises, please provide detailed, I should say super detailed. I am not going to complain that you use too many sheets, never. Super detailed solutions. Okay. Should be good for you and for 33 plus N star 33 others. Okay, others, and submit to I'll mail to you, because I don't want to, my mail ID is there on your on the brochure, but that is that contains so many other things that it will get. So I'll create a separate mail ID and I'll mail it to you.
Is given to us so that locally we can cross check and then send it to you.
Which one?
Whatever the assignment sheet you have provided to us, the numericals. So if you give the answers for that final
answer. No. You send me to me, I'll give you feedback. Because you know, over the years I have changed the numbers, but I have not resolved the problems. I changed the numbers because everybody knew what the old answer was, or there was some problem, or the steam table changed, so I had to, that those values were not available, so I changed them, something like that. And I will put a deadline for submission. What? Not 2 weeks, 2 months in advance. See, today is February 25, March 25, April 25, 16 days, and I think none of you has more than 4 problems, so one, March 25, you said it, yes sir.
Sir, prior to the workshop, actual date of the workshop, we should run a live demo, say 1 hour lecture.
For what?
Testing will be, the testing will be for 1 month earlier only. The testing will be starting 1 month earlier. 15 days earlier or say. Every day 1 or 2 hours the testing will be there. Before 15 days before the workshop.
We are the coordinator, we will be at the only.
Yes. Yes. Yeah, yeah, you have to be there. You have to be there, it's compulsory.
One thing you tell me, out of these 34, how many centers are such that they have not been a remote center for Professor Fatak's and Professor Sudarshan's earlier thing? About 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, about half, say, roughly half. So the problem is majority for these are, they are nauke people, I think. They are newcomers. For the other 17.
Last time Sudarshan's workshop, AVU was new to everybody.
Yes, but now it is new only to half of them. Okay. Of course, for all these people it is new, but there is some person there who has worked. So the network team is perhaps knowledgeable about it.